So Frank was also into kind of, we'll go back to the album, Frank was kind of into like old movies and old kind of, you know, Hollywood B-movies and things like that, which brings mm-hmm. it into cheapness
yeah.
on the album. He mentions, you know, an old 50s movie and things like that. Yeah. So do you think that was kind of an influence to some of his music as well?
Well, certainly his sense of humor, because what he really liked about those movies was the very poor production value that you could see on screen, you know. And so the appeal of that is that, you know, you have an idea and you try to, you know, present this idea to people, and no matter what obstacle is in your way, you still push forward. And so these kind of movies that got made, and you wonder how they got made, because, you know, some of them are just so incredibly bad, where it's, you know, the background is a canvas that has a cave painted on it, but the canvas falls off the wall.
That sounds a lot like Liverpool Live TV in some cases.
Yeah. So, you know, it's that kind of thing where the production values are what he was looking for. Not so much the storyline. It's just any opportunity to see an epic failure of you know, production values was the entertainment factor.
Cool. We're still talking about Roxy and Elsewhere. Mm-hmm. The last song on the album, Bebop Tango of the old Jazzman's Church. Are you going to do all of that with the dance as well?
Yeah. We've been doing that. Every city, you know, you pull up some dancers, and sometimes you get some interesting things. The other night in Leeds, people were pretty reserved, and in the venue, it was this grand theater from the 1800s. And so inside, when all the lights were on, all these crystal fixtures and whatnot, it looked like a scene from Close Encounters of the Third Kind, like when the spaceship is coming down. So somehow a convoluted story happened where, when I was inviting people up on the stage, you know, I was mentioning this Close Encounters kind of thing, and I one of the themes we've had on the tour is that sometimes when I have people come on the stage, I will have them reenact something that's like from a National Geographic wildlife adventure where somebody has to either be a bird with some type of mating dance or some other thing that gets acted out. But in this case, there was a situation where there was a little boy who was probably 10 years old, and I had him act as a freshly born giraffe, and then his mom was supposed to be his protector, and then there was this crazy drunk guy that was the lion. You know, but then I was talking about the place as being in a space orchard because of the, you know, Close Encounters thing. So that became sort of the joke of the night, that we were all in the space orchard, and the mom didn't try to help the baby giraffe. The lion just went for him, you know. So it's like this whole thing happened during the Bebop Tango. Excellent. And it's all part of the audience participation. But that song is really hard to play. The improv part at the end, that's easy. But the
well, Frank actually says in this edit, you know, I want to make sure we get all the right notes on the tape, because this is like a really hard song to play.
Yeah, it's incredibly difficult.
Now, the album is about 48.
It's 40 years
minutes.
Old.
It's 40 years old, but it's about 50 minutes in length. Are you going to add anything?
I think it's a little bit longer than that, but we play everything on it, and the length of the songs varies depending on solos, mm-hmm. you know. So.
Excellent. Okay, so 1984, I believe it was, my son Dweezil is going to play the guitar solo from a Them or Us album called Charlena. Was that your first?
The first time I played with Frank was here in London, or in the UK, in London, when I was 12, and it was probably 1982, at the Hammersmith Odeon.
Right.
And I'd only been playing guitar for 9 months.
How was that? Were you nervous?
Oh, yeah, of course. But the thing that was cool about it was I could only really play in the key of A, because that's all I really had practiced at that point. And the song that I was going to play on was in the key of B. So Frank fixed that problem by giving that band a hand signal to modulate down a full step mm-hmm. for the solo. And then when I was done, they went back to the other key, you know.
Oh, that's nice. That's,
yeah, it worked out.
That is excellent. Where are you at the tour at the minute? Have you got much more of the tour left to go?
We've been out for almost 7 weeks now, and we have I think 2 weeks left. We have some more dates in the UK, and then we move off to Scandinavia and Finland, and we end in Estonia, And then we go back to the U.S. and have a couple more shows before Christmas. And then there's a whole other leg of the tour that begins at the end of January. So there's quite a bit more left to do.
That's a hell of a run. Are you going to get any time off for Christmas?
Yeah, for sure I'll have time off for Christmas, for, you know, with the kids and everything.
Have you ever thought of doing like a Zappa festival, like a 2-day Zappa festival?
There's been some talk of that. It's just hard to organize all those kind of things because there could be, you know, film festival side of it. There could be different kinds of musical presentations, whether it's orchestral or rock or a combination of both. So there's a lot of stuff that could be done, but it just takes a lot of effort to.
Yeah, I was thinking, you know, you could have a day of kind of the films, 200 Motels, and some of the animations and things like that, and then all the bands coming in and doing like tributes to Frank, you know, like albums and things like that.
Yeah, well, I mean,
with you obviously headlining and doing.
Yeah, show. I mean, there's ideas that have been tossed around for that kind of stuff, but again, you know, it takes. Takes quite a bit of effort.
Okay, so let's narrow that down then to just one album. What about Joe's Garage?
Well, that would be a really hard one to play for sure. There's a lot of really crazy polyrhythms and stuff on that record. But besides that, there's a lot of heavy-duty background vocal arrangements. So that's one that people have been asking us about. And ideally, if we ever did do it... it would be interesting to try to do something that had a visual element with some interactive sort of live animation type of stuff.
I mean, you could keep Frank obviously as a central scrutinizer and then, well, maybe bring animations in to explain the story.
It would be tough to keep him as the central scrutinizer because you'd have to be then playing everything to a click track, you know. And
so you need to bring someone new in, I suppose.
And it's tough.
Yeah, you know. That is tough. So Dweezil, thank you very much for taking time out to speak to us again, and especially me again, you know, a year later. So thanks very much, and hopefully maybe next year we'll see you again.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Thank you.
All right, thanks. Mm-hmm.